SpaceX founder Elon Musk said on Saturday that the first orbital stack of the Starship rocket should be ready for flight in the coming weeks, taking the unorthodox billionaire a step closer to his dream of orbital and then interplanetary travel. Elon Musk tweeted that SpaceX is just waiting for regulatory approval. SpaceX plans to have its first Starship orbital test flight be launched from Texas and then splash down off the coast of an island in Hawaii. The orbital flight test would mark the first time SpaceX stacks both elements of its massive Starship system together. This would be a key development in its attempt to build a rocket that could one day land on Mars. Whenever it happens, the orbital test will demonstrate Starship maneuvers that cannot be simulated using computers. SpaceX intends to collect as much data as possible during flight to quantify entry dynamics and better understand what the vehicle experiences in a flight regime that is extremely difficult to accurately predict or replicate computationally. The flight data gleaned from Starship's test will anchor any changes in vehicle design and build better models to use in Starship internal simulations. Now let's look at Starship, the most powerful rocket ever built. At first, Starship is not only the name of a full rocket, but also to the upper stage. But the name of the first stage, which is where the booster stays, is Super Heavy. It's made up of stainless steel and stood 120 meters or 394 feet tall. The Starship uses new Raptor engines for every stage. The Raptor is the most ambitious engine ever made in the history of mankind. It is powered by subcooled liquid methane and subcooled liquid oxygen, using a staged combustion cycle, unlike the simpler open cycle gas generator system. The closed cycle makes the engines extremely powerful and up to 98% efficient. SpaceX Raptor's engines began flight testing on the Starhopper prototype in July 2019 and became the first full-flown staged combustion rocket ever flown. Raptor also produces the highest combustion chamber pressure ever reached by an operational rocket engine at 330 bar or 33,000 kilopascals. The Starship is designed to send over 100 tons or 100 people into space, with a fully reusable design and liquid oxygen and methane fuel. These features mean that a team can fly to Mars, refuel using the planet's resources, then return home. That, in turn, paves the way for some of SpaceX's most ambitious goals, like a self-sustaining city on Mars by 2050, and further-flung ventures that will turn humanity into a multi-planetary species. Even the landing of Starship is very unique. Instead of using a parachute and landing in the ocean, the rocket does something called a belly flop maneuver. The landing begins by first switching off the engine, falling from the sky, belly first, or in the horizontal position. This is supposed to decrease the velocity as much as possible, then swinging back into a vertical position, lighting the two Raptor engines and land the tail down on its landing legs. This is much like a skydiver using their arms and legs to control a free-fall. When the skydiver falls belly first, they have the most drag on their body as possible, which means their terminal velocity is at a minimum. If they were to flip their feet or head first, there would be much less surface area for the air to push against the skydiver. Starship can also control its terminal velocity. Think of the flaps as a skydiver's arms and legs. If the flaps are more extended, the drag on the vehicle will increase, and if they're folded in, the drag will decrease, thus making the terminal velocity faster. And because the booster is fully reusable, SpaceX plans to catch it. To know more about catching a Super Heavy booster, click on that I button or check the link in the description below. In the end, Starship is one massive rocket, intended to make space travel faster, cheaper, and reliable. It's so good that even NASA chose Starship as a moon lander for their Artemis mission. And according to Musk, Starship will keep evolving and will even have many different versions of the rocket. But those are long awaited in the list as we have yet to see Starship's first orbital spaceflight. Next time on Discover Zen, we will be discussing why does the SpaceX Starship belly flop? Thank you so much for watching our video. If you liked what you saw, please click that like button and subscribe. Let us know in the comments below where you would like to see Starship used the most.